Greetings all, Devious Monkey here. Okay, got some big plans going on. First things first is the overhead camera setup. It was crap. I didn't like it. I tried to make it work. It didn't work. It was just too flimsy. That little arm, and that's my fault, because the little arm was basically made for a cell phone. I thought that the ZV-1 would be light enough for it, and it's just not. Plus, it's just flimsy. It's just crap. It didn't work. Any movement whatsoever, anytime I tapped the table, anytime anything happened, it just jiggled. Now, even though I built that big-ass wooden contraption and that was sturdy, there was no getting around the arm. The arm itself was junk. So I have now relegated that to being a LED light holder for the new setup. And after watching tons of videos last night, I came across a rather ingenious setup that I had thought about at first, and then I thought that it would be too hard to switch it over, but found out that it's not. I can use an external monitor mount arm to do what I want to do. And the video I watched, fortunately, had all the links in it. That's why I link everything when I do stuff, because it makes it easy for you, because I like it when people make it easy for me. So they basically used a single external monitor mount that comes up from the side, straight over, and that shit is holding, I mean, it's big enough to hold like a gigantic monitor without jiggling. So it's sturdy, and it just has the typical clamp mount on the bottom. I might reinforce this table a little bit, at least put a couple of maybe one bys on the top and the bottom, just to give it something more to purchase other than just the desktop, but we'll cross that bridge when we get to it. So I got one of those things. Now, there were two sizes. There was one that comes up 31 inches, and there was one that only came up 17 and a half. I felt like the 31 was too high, but I felt that the 17 and a half was way too low. After sitting here with a tape measure and rolling up, the 31 inch is actually perfect, because now that will be high enough to go over both camera setups now. And as you can see, I moved the second A6600 over to my right side rather than my left. And that was another thing that I did, and we'll get to that in a second. I'll tell you why I moved it. But anyways, so that monitor mount comes up over, and it's up high enough to clear both cameras, lights, whatever is around here. I can then have it going straight down, and it looks rock steady. I mean, he mounted a DSLR onto it, and it didn't move. So I think I'll get by with the ZV-1. Now, in the interest of not making myself insane about how shitty the ZV-1 batteries are, I have now ordered a 10-foot USB cable that I will use with the Sony plug adapter, and I'm going to basically cinch that across the top, down the side, across the table, and then it's only exposed for, you know, like less than a foot over here, and this is out of the way. I don't walk through here too much, and it'll be perfect. I also got another cord for my Aperture MC, because I have that up there with a 6-foot cord, and it's ugly, draped across and hanging down, and I put an extension on it so it's sticking up on the side. No one sees it. You can't see it. People that come in here don't give a shit, but I see it and I give a shit. So I got two 10-foot cords, one to power the ZV-1, one to power that, so that the cables are cinched out of the way and I don't have to worry about it. Now, the other thing that was bothering me and why I moved all this shit around is just general placement of everything. There's so much crap in here and there's just not that much room, that I've been smacking my head on the light, knocking the light out of the way, tripping over the damn bottoms of the stands and everything and over the cords, and that bothered me. So again, when I redid all this table and everything, I moved the tripods in such a way that I brought the legs in so that they were in further but out enough that nothing was gonna tip over, even if I bump into it. Plus, I just need to watch what the hell I'm doing. Then I took the power cables, and I only have one power cable that's going right here to this tripod, to the CineRig, because remember, I'm powering it all off of that Gold Mount Indie Pro stuff. And by having the dummy batteries going into the camera and into the monitor, into the back of that thing, I just have one power cord that runs over to here on this side again, where I'm gonna run the power for the ZV-1. So that's out of the way. It goes straight down along the tripod where I'm not gonna step anyways, comes around the table and goes into the corner here. That's good. What was getting me a lot was the cord to the softbox, to the Niebuhr SL60 in the softbox. I had it plugged over here into this thing, in which case it runs where I walk all the time across two spots that I cross over. And then if I ran it around there, over to here or over to there, it was just in the way. Last night when I was laying in bed, I had an epiphany and I thought to myself, why the hell am I running it around to the front and side of the light? Can't I just drop it down the back and I'm not even stepping over there because that's where I had the little shitty desk, little TV tray thing for my company laptop. I don't step over there. Why am I not running it there? So today I walked in here and I was like, what an idiot. I could have been running it there the whole time and the cord wouldn't even have been in the way. Now, I did have to rearrange the power cords because I have one of those things that plugs into both plugs in the wall, and then it gave me four actual plugs that you can spin so that you know it accommodates whatever direction you need to go in, and then has a series of USB ports that I don't use. That wasn't enough because I got a ton of shit plugged in over there, so I had to run another thing and I got that taken care of. It's not pretty, but it's there and it's taken care of. Now the light's taken care of. Now I have a lot more room in here, at least as far as my feet go, that I can walk around and not trip over anything. And that should take care of that. Now that's also why I moved this A6600, because before I had it on this side, it was like, there's just too much going on over there with the softbox and everything that I kept running into the light trying to avoid the camera. So now it's over here right at the tip of the desk, and that one's right in front of the table. So everything is now where it needs to be, I think, optimally. I'm not really gonna, unless I start trying to drill into the ceiling and hang shit from there. Don't think I haven't thought about that, but that's gonna be real involved, and my attic scares me and I don't wanna go up there by myself. So this is the way it's gonna be. The other thing that I'm thinking is about how damn boring this blue wall is over here. You know, a lot of people say, print your shit. It's not doing you any good to have your pictures that you've taken, and you've taken some good pictures, if you're not gonna print them out and show them off or give them away or sell them or whatever. Okay, so I have the two prints of the two different Virginia Beach sunsets that I printed out because I have a big ass Canon photo printer here, and I thought I need to print some of my shit out. So I printed those out and I got them framed and they're hanging on the wall. That's it. Two oddly placed pictures of sunsets and that's it. So the wall's pretty boring. Yes, it's pretty blue and all that kind of crap. You don't ever really see it. You can kind of see the corner of it every once in a while if I move the camera, but otherwise, bleh, it's boring. So then I thought to myself, I wonder if I can do something with some LED lighting. So I looked up on Amazon and I found LED light strips. And all right, first of all, let me just tell you, all of this came about from watching Make Art Now. He has like these amazing videos and he built this amazing studio. I don't have that kind of space. I definitely don't have his skill as far as building everything and building it out and all that kind of crap. And you know, so I'm limited to what I have. I have a vision, sometimes I have money, and I can order from Amazon. Every once in a while I go to Home Depot and I buy shit. But you can see how that turns out a lot. I shittily put things together, they don't work. I thought to myself, when I watched how he had built his long table, and his friend was actually like routering out grooves into it to run lighting and cables and all that kind of shit. And I thought to myself, I wonder if I can do something like that. Even if I take like a not a 2x4, but a 1x4 or 1x6 and just do it for a certain length. And then I can adhere the LED lights to the back of it, put a couple of brackets on there and bam, jam those onto the wall. Now the reflection of the LED lights behind that will come out of the top and the bottom. And you know, I mean, I can change the colors at my whim. I mean, think of how many times I change the color of the lights around here. Right now I'm doing the yellow, like the lemony yellow, just because it makes it seem like it's really bright and nice in here when it's actually really dark, except for right here. So I thought, oh, you know what? I think I can do that. The lights themselves were under $20. How much is a 1x4? $5? You know, so I mean, I think I can do that. So that's something that I have in my mind. That's all coming over the course of the next several days. Once it gets here and I put it all together and it's working the way I want it to, I'll do another video and I'll show you exactly what I've done and I'll link everything. That way, if you think it's a good idea, you can go out and get it too. I'm pretty inspired by Make Art Now, just because of the fact that he did all this stuff and made it all smart, and he's using Alexa. I don't want to say it too loud because she'll hear me. and, you know, with all the things. Oh yeah, I did order smart plugs so that I can plug all this shit in here. My goal is to come in here and ask her to turn on the studio lights and have, or I want to try to figure out if I can do this as a skill. I basically want to say something and have all the office lights go out and all the studio lights come on in one fell swoop. If I can do that, I'll be happy. So if I can do it, I'll show you. That's all I've got for today. I just kind of wanted to go over my mad scientist plans for this studio and let you know kind of what I got coming and all that kind of stuff and approximately when it's gonna come. And we'll go from there. Tomorrow's sort of like a day where I gotta do something a little bit more exciting than me sitting here droning on. Drop me a comment down below. Let me know what you'd like to see me do. Keep in mind, it's shit outside. It's just been pouring for like 2 or 3 days. That's all I got for you today. As always, thanks for joining me. Like, subscribe, and all that shit. And remember, kids, forward and up.